okay, I feel unstoppable. Losing's impossible. Go against the team, the thing they know not to do. Bright lights, game on the line, do what I gotta do. Time after time, we do the impossible. You ain't made it till you got stylists go out and shop for you. You ain't made it till they pour on top of you. Parading through the city, the whole block come out for you. We just getting started, y'all finna see what we bout to do. Boy, stop, you ain't here, I'm the real truth. Hunters real blue, strips on them still new. Shopping at Dover Street, I'm dripping like mildew. They say you don't visit the hood, dog, I still do. A real one, only difference, my bill's bigger. I'm still with ya, I just got rich a little quicker. The same man, God handed me his game plan. I ain't perfect, far from it, what can I say, man? I feel unstoppable, losing's impossible. Go against the team, the thing they know not to do. Bright lights, game on the line, do what I gotta do. Time after time, we do the impossible. It felt like yesterday, I was just driving my grandma's Chevrolet. From South Carolina to Maryland, I take the jet today. I'm still on the come up, I'm still building my resume. I still got a lot to prove, but still I'm heavyweight. I still gotta watch my moves. They tried to defamate my character, but I won't let them. It's always checkmate. I'm still screaming, the world hope she. Mother Nature's my first shawty. Watch how I go ballistic, and I'm so terrific. Accounts is copacetic. I don't.
EA Sports coverage of the NFL brings us to South Florida at Hard Rock Stadium here in Miami. Today, we're set for a good AFC matchup between the Tennessee Titans and the Miami Dolphins. Here's Jason Sanders now to get this one started, and we are underway from Miami. Here's Trenton Cannon on the return from his end zone. And he's only going to make it to the 13-yard. Further. In motion is Austin Hooper. They'll start on the ground. It's Derrick Henry. Despite some tough running, he's still wrangled down shy of the 15. They go play action with Willis. He's going to fire one deep over the middle. And he bats it away, and it falls down incomplete.
Quarterbacks work all the time on manipulating a defense with their eyes and their head movement. In this case, he just scared the receiver down. That allowed for excellent coverage, able to knock that one away.
So trouble already here on their opening drive. This is 3rd and 9.
Third down, it's Willis.
That's complete to Treylon Burks. And he will have a Titans first down as they're able to get the third down conversion.
Well, that certainly has to feel good. It's not all the time that the play caller should get all the credit. Sometimes I think in the huddle the quarterback just says, hey, who's going to make a play for me? I just need something right here. And the end result there, nice first down. Drive keeps moving.
And nowhere to run for Willis. He goes down. Buried behind the line by Christian Wilkins.
And this is what you've got to do against a quarterback like him. You've got to keep him in the pocket and not let him get to the perimeter, because once he gets outside, that's where he can really hurt you.
On second down, here's Henry. And that play going absolutely nowhere as he's belted before he could get out of the backfield.
Here's Willis on 3rd and long.
All right, rifles one, and that's going to be intercepted. Picked off by Eric Rowe. So a big chunk of yardage will be marked off there for that PI call.
And now you know why receivers and the guys throwing the ball, to collaborate and just heave it up sometimes, because you can get these types of calls that go against the defense. Pass interference, and they gain over 30 yards of real estate on that one.
Inside handoff, Henry. And he'll fight forward on the straight-ahead running for just a couple of yards. Second down. The last run got a couple. Here's second and eight. And the timing a bit off that time as that one falls to the ground.
Speed is the name of the game when it comes to RPOs, and sometimes you can be a little too quick, thus inaccurate, incomplete.
So the failure to connect on second down, that leaves him staring up here at a third and eight. Here's Willis. And that will be incomplete.
Normally, he's pretty reliable. Usually catches what's thrown to him. On that play, he simply dropped it.
Now on fourth down, here's Ryan Stonehouse to punt for Tennessee. Back deep is Tyreek Hill. And now a high kick trying to pin him back. It'll be 37 yards there on the punt. And the Dolphins' drive will start deep in their own territory with a first and 10. Two on the Dolphins now with a first and 10 at their own 14-yard line. Throwing now is Tagovailoa. Gonna look deep for Wilson. And now this is intercepted. My goodness. Picked off by Caleb Farley. And the Titans are gonna take possession here at their own 47-yard line.
Well, this had trouble written all over from the start. He's got two extra defensive backs in the game he's got to deal with. They're in a dime set. So everywhere he's looking, he's seeing a different color jersey. And sure enough, this one winds up being intercepted.
This is intercepted. Picked up by Xavier Howard. And the Dolphins are going to get this back to their own 34-yard line. Defensively that time, they were in zone coverage. As a rookie QB, what lesson can you learn there?
Well, understand this. You saw zone in college, and the defensive backs reacted, but they don't react like they do on this level. So when they're in zone and they see the ball coming to them, they'll react at least a half a second faster. You've got to know where you want to go with the ball and be decisive with it. Otherwise, the end result can be something you don't like.
And this is taken in at the five. It's a big play there for Miami. 61 yards. In today's NFL, you know, we talk about quarterbacks and their speed and accuracy, but there's still something about a guy slinging one downfield. Here's Mostert. And the hole closes quickly here. He can fight only to about the four. Only a yard that time. Second and goal.
If you're going to keep these guys out of the end zone, you've got to be able to commit to stopping the run. And that's a nice job there, getting the safeties involved in run support.
They'll try a little trickery here on the end around. And he will push his way forward down to about the 3-yard line. Two runs in a row, but only 2 yards to show for it. This Titan defense, they just will not give in easily. Looking for another stop, third and goal. Now Tua. That is caught by Waddle. Touchdown, Miami. The 3-yard touchdown pass. And the Dolphins use the early turnover to get on the board first here in this one. Well, that's just how they drew it up, CD. His first read was there, got it to him quickly, and into the end zone.
Absolutely excellent execution by all involved. And the coordinator, yeah, give him credit, found the perfect play call. Quarterback let it fly as soon as the target came free, and his guy made a nice catch. Just how you draw it up in practice and then execute it in the game.
So look at this. They got the 7-0 lead in the pocket, and they're going to try an onside kick. Now whistles come in. We're going to get a timeout here by the offense. They'll have two remaining as we step aside here in this first quarter. Now after the touchdown, ready to kick it away is Sanders. Cannon now elects to bring this out. And he doesn't even get this to the 10. He's taken down at the 9.
Anytime you field a kickoff inside your own end zone, you've got to be decisive about whether you're bringing it out or not. Sometimes that indecision can really cost you. That may have been what happened on that play.
The Titans offense set to begin the drive. For this offense, Charles, you got to think kind of crucial here to put something together on this drive, because remember last time out, they threw the interception on the very first play.
And you can't afford to let this defense keep building any more momentum. They're playing awfully well.
And he is not going to get away. The rush was too strong, and this is going to wind up a safety.
All right, partner, Deuce is wild on this sequence. Two plays, two sacks, and now 2 points thanks to the safety. Offensively, there just didn't seem to be much of a plan when they came out on attack. That let the defense create a little chaos up front and set up one of their guys to make a play and get through and record the sack.
And he'll go out of bounds after getting this across the 15. First down, Miami, as they get set to start the drive. This drive here beginning probably with a pair of motivated grooves. Remember, the offense scored a touchdown on their last time out, looking to repeat that. Charles's defense, they were very frustrated after giving up 6 the last time on. Oh, looking for Waddle, but it's intercepted. Picked off by Caleb Farley. And the Titans are going to take possession of the football. And not the first quarter that he was hoping for. Now 2 interceptions thrown.
Well, the good ones, they find a way to compartmentalize, right? Put these behind them, have that short memory, but understand why they threw the 2 interceptions. They go on and usually play a pretty decent game. Other quarterbacks, they have a hard time getting past it and often put the ball up for grabs the rest of the ball game.
After the pickup of 5, here's 2nd and 5. Here's Willis now off the play fake. And he's going to be taken down. Pressure gets there back at the 39-yard line. Multiple defenders there to drop him for a loss of 4. These sacks now, they're starting to pile up, Charles. And that front 7 defensively, they've had their way with this offensive line.
And I think at this stage, we have to start thinking about different play calls. We've got to start helping this quarterback out, because the entire game he's been under siege. I don't care what the down and distance, they've got to get the ball out of his hands a lot quicker. I thought that was a completed pass until he came in and forced the ball from his hands. Not only did he make a nice play, he brings up 4th down.
And his kick is good. He got every bit of that one, as it's good from 56 yards out. And they are on the board. It's now 9-3. Well, still some climbing left to do to get back to even, but forcing a turnover and getting the field goal there, that's a small step toward erasing the early deficit.
Absolutely. That interception field goal, that's the beginning of what they hope will be several steps towards erasing that deficit and building a lead of their own by the time this game is over.
And this will not be brought out. It's a touchback. Dolphins at the line, ready for their next drive. The last drive for this offense, Charles, you remember it ended in one play, that quick interception, but they do still have the lead as they start this drive here.
And that's something to focus on for them as well, because it's not quite no